Hi guys, thanks for watching another episode of our Reno journey. In the previous vlog, we focused more on the foyer and kitchen areas. Today, we'll be taking a look at the rest of the house. Enjoy! Big thanks to HomeTrust for sponsoring this part of the video. I remember the start of our renovation journey, we met up with nearly 10 IDs before deciding on our one. The process was tiring and tedious, and there were so many things to consider. If you are as lost as we were, or you just want a clearer picture, fret not. HomeTrust is here to help. HomeTrust is a trusted community review site which offers advice and feedback from hundreds of reviews to help homeowners make a better decision when engaging an ID firm. HomeTrust prides itself in transparency and unbiasedness when it comes to their review section. It is company policy that they allow homeowners to publish their true experience after engaging with a particular ID firm. Do check them out at HomeTrust.sg, or you can just click the link in the description box below. Let's get back to the video. Okay, next up is the living room. This side, it's the display cabinet, but I'm not going to show you guys that first. So this is the view from our display cabinet to the dining and living room. So this is actually our table, 2.4 meters in length. We've got kind of a stone textured legs here. For this worktop, we actually chose a sintered stone worktop, and we chose double profile, so it's thicker, looks more luxurious and expensive. We're really excited to see how this turns out. So this will be the centerpiece of our house. It will be right along here. This is actually 90 to 92 cm from the floor. It's not really a bar counter height, but it's also not like a dining table height. It's like a little bit in between, like a worktop height. And then we've got some matching high chairs to go along with it. In the next episodes, you will probably see the completed version of this. Moving on to the living room, I'm gonna show you the TV console. It's not really a console, it's more of like just a shelf actually. And for this one, we opted for a plain dark grey laminate, because this wall is gonna be lime washed, and then we wanted contrast, but we didn't want a contrast in like material. You get what I mean? So like, we don't want this to be stone and then this to be lime wash, because then we think it will be a little bit too much. The TV is gonna be up here, and then the sockets are down below. So the reason why they're upside down is so no need to like turn the wire like around and plug it in. You can just bring it down from on top and then plug it in upside down. But there was a bit of a miscom. So now, you see this area is not gonna allow the plug to plug in here freely, because there's not enough space for the end of the wire to curve here. So in the end, we're gonna have to flip this around anyway, and then the wire is gonna have to come through here, and then we have to plug it up. We have to plug it in upright position anyways. Okay guys, so now it's the most exciting part. This is gonna be the biggest carpentry in the house. It is also the most expensive. Here it is. So this is our display cabinet. If you're wondering why this part is still not enclosed, it's because on this part, we're gonna have glass doors. So it's gonna be two big glass doors here and here of different widths. This one is gonna open this way, and then this one is gonna open this way. Okay, and then for the top here, so we're gonna have two doors also, two leaf, this way and this way, right? And then for here, this way. Okay, and then because this is in very close, it's just right next to our dining table, which is gonna be around here. This is where we'll put some utensils. Here is a two-tier drawer. So utensils, glasses, cups and all that. And then we've got a lot of storage space for maybe like smaller plates and all that. So we're gonna have probably I don't know, some drinks here. You can put some alcohol. I've got some Lego sets that I want to display here. So this back of the display cabinet is actually laminate, and we've chosen this finish. It's like a marble finish. The pattern looks very bold and stark if you're right up close to it, but actually if you take a step back, it blends in quite well. This laminate color, again, is this lime wash one, but compared to the kitchen one, it's not as warm. It's a little bit cooler. It's still a little bit warm, but it's not exactly the same. So these are the handles that we built into the cupboard. We decided to not have like exposed handles, like the actual physical handle with the bar and everything, because number one, cost, and then number two, I think it doesn't fit the aesthetics of the house, the theme of the house, and then number three, you might get your clothes hooked on them. So yeah, this is the inside. So that's a problem. So actually, you can see up here, that is our false ceiling with our cove light. So it actually does touch this false ceiling part, so we might have to put a piece of rubber stopper up there so it doesn't hit and then cause damage over time. All these shelves inside here, they are pretty much all adjustable. Our ID said she'll just give us as many planks as she can, and then if we wanted like taller spaces in between the planks, then we can just remove them. And this laminate, again, it's this like fabric looking laminate. For this one, we've gone for a grayer color. So all the exposed parts that will be covered with glass doors, we have LEDs included in them. It's not entirely completed yet, but the things are all pretty much inside already. So these shelves are not gonna be adjustable, so we have already fixed the height of these shelves. Okay, next I'm gonna show you guys the master bedroom. Actually, the common room, nothing much has been done because we don't have any carpentry inside here. This is the IKEA day bed that we have gotten. So if need be, this can be converted into a queen size bed. So that's the mattress right there, and then these are our two mirrors that will be going into the common and master bedroom toilet. So let's start with the common bathroom. So this is vanity. So over here, we decided to go with a really big top mount sink. This is about 90 centimeters across, and then we'll have a very big sink, and then the faucet will be in this hole, will be coming out from this hole, off-centered. The reason why we did that is because I think it's easier to clean and maintain, and then yeah, because if it's at the back, we don't really have much space because of how wide the actual sink is. So this is the color that we've chosen, again, in this lime wash laminate color. In the master bedroom one, we've gone with a darker laminate color for the carcass. It's dark wood, and then this one is the same laminate. This side of the toilet, I've already shown you guys in the other video, so you can check it out if you haven't already. This is the master bedroom. I'm gonna show you guys from the other angle. Here. Oh, it's a bit messy. Okay, so this is the vanity table. We've got two drawers here, one that you can see through and then one that you can't. This area is gonna be for like daily use items. And then hair dryer will also be here. We have some switches and a PowerPoint here. And then this is more storage up here. Just close it so you can see better. Okay, now that it's all closed, you can have a better look. So this is the laminate that we've chosen, and then the carcass is a dark wood color. that is similar to this one. And on this side, small little area to hang longer things to wear, so like suits, long pants and all that stuff. And then on the bottom, we got two drawers for this side. So we foresee actually removing one of the shelves from the bottom to make it taller and more accessible. And then we'll keep these two shelves for like daily wear stuff. And then this will be shared between me and my wife. So just now this area, this is my side. And then this is shared between me and my wife. And then the top will be maybe for bed sheets and all that stuff. And then this area, this will be all my wife's stuff. So long dresses here and then shorter ones here. Okay. Then this is the vanity table. It's gonna be see-through. So we're gonna put some of our stuff here, jewelry, watches and all that. And then we've added a lock also, just in case, I guess. Okay, so that's all for this episode of the vlog about carpentry. It's quite a long episode, so thank you for watching till the end. The next episode, the worktops for the kitchen in here, and the compact plus for the toilets, and then the glass doors for this area. And then after that, we're gonna be moving to final plumbing and final electrical works. And then after that, we're gonna do cleaning. And stay tuned for more. Bye bye.